The next time someone complains about their commute, bring up Beijing's National Expressway, which had a traffic jam that lasted for almost 2 weeks. Why do we have so much traffic? Hey there, motorists. Trace here for DNews. Thanks for watching. Traffic is part of driving. But why does it exist? Mathematically speaking, traffic happens. Three things affect the inevitability of traffic along the best travel routes: speed, density, and flow. A study in the SIAM Journal on Mathematical Analysis back in 2011 was the first to create a mathematical model which included every car on the road and how bottlenecks affect a jam, like that monster one back in Beijing in 2010. It turns out one single car can start a backup, which affects all the cars around them and continues in a wave throughout the rest of the traffic. This wave is called phantom traffic. I don't know if you've ever experienced phantom traffic, but it's when cars on the highway stop for no reason. MIT researchers put drivers on a circular track and told them to maintain a constant slow speed. And very quickly, jams formed anyway. Researchers call these jamatons because mathematically they're similar to waves called solitons. They can be frustrating, but honestly, it's just math. When density reaches a certain point, research from MIT found, a single car braking can start a wave. But to be clear, it's not actually that driver's fault. Mathematically, if everyone followed the exact same rules, there comes a point where car density is high enough that the flow and speed are affected because of human reaction. They happen not because one person screwed up, but because of how humans observe and react to traffic. It's kind of like human nature. Science loves to compare our experiences with animals around us, so when it comes to traffic, that animal is the humble ant. Have you ever seen an ant traffic jam? Of course you haven't! A multi-country study from universities in Germany, India, and Japan looked at an ant species from India to look at how ants manage traffic. And holy crap, they're basically perfect drivers. Ants spread pheromone scents to indicate safe routes to forage. Their receptors keep them on these pheromone roads and help them communicate with each other while they're traveling. It turns out, as more and more ants travel along the same road, they travel closer together but don't slow down as density increases, unlike the cars in MIT studies and, of course, in the real world. Remember, as density increases, humans, we tend to slow down. Instead, ants all go the same speed, no matter how many are on the road, and they put the needs of the many first. Ants taking food to the colony are automatically given right of way, and although there are no lanes, ants will move out of the way to keep things flowing. Humans, we kind of have a hard time putting others' interests before our own quite so easily, which is part of the problem. Ants are part of a colony, but humans, we're egoists. We're individualistic, and that's another source of traffic. If someone drives a bit slower than you on the highway, say, do you speed around them, or do you slow down just a little and tuck in behind them? I think we all know what happens there. Speeding around them and continuing on our way, obviously. Perfect little traffic ants, however, slow down behind ants that are carrying large things, like leaves. The ants behind it will travel slower, but everyone actually got where they are going faster overall, because the ants didn't have to compensate for all these other people speeding around this slow, cargo-laden ant. Essentially, if we all made tiny sacrifices, we would all end up getting everywhere faster because traffic waves, jams, and backups would pretty much disappear. Phantom traffic waves would, too. Maybe we can all learn a thing or two from ants when it comes to efficient driving, but we can also learn a thing or two from Toyota. Toyota is fueling the future with a new Toyota Mirai. Using the most abundant element in the universe, hydrogen, the new Mirai is looking to the future with sustainability in mind. But how does traffic make you feel? Get cathartic down in the comments, and make sure you come back to DNews every day for more videos, and subscribe so you don't miss a single one.